Hey everyone, welcome to this tutorial. In this video, I'll be showing you how to create a table with the help of Elementor Page Builder. Now, with JetElements plugin for Elementor, it is possible to create tables within Elementor Editor. So, as you see, you can add various types of content to your tables, and you can style them in very different ways. You can also filter the items in your tables, like so, and you can add icons. So now I'll show you what theme I'm using in this tutorial. I'm using Monster 2, a multi-purpose modular Elementor WordPress theme that you can get if you follow the link in the description, and you can also get the JetElements plugin if you click the link down below in the description. So now we're in Elementor Editor, and what I need to do is to go to the Elements panel. And if I already have JetElements plugin installed, I only need to search for table, and the widget I need will look like this. And I'll drop it onto a section. And in the content tab, I see these three tabs. And it's pretty easy to understand how this module works. You don't need to know any code, even basic HTML or CSS, nothing, because everything is done within Elementor with no custom CSS. So what we're going to do is to create a table similar to this one. This one column will be of a different color. So here in the table header tab, you can add the headings for your columns. When you open one item, you see Content, Advanced, and Style. In the Content tab, you can add the title and choose whether you want to use an icon or an image for this particular cell. In the Advanced tab, you can set the column span and the width for the column. If you want the width to be set automatically, just leave this value as 0. And here in the Style tab, you can set the text color and the background color for this particular cell. What I want to do is to leave the text color as white and set the background color as purple. And I will also change the color of these two columns that I have left. So we're done with the table header. Now let's move on to the table body. As you see, you've got, again, a number of items in here. And the start row item only means that with this item, you want to start a new row. So I've got three cells in this row, and let's say I want to add one more row, which will be having three items again. So I press add item, and here I've got a new item appearing, which is named cell, and by default the action is add new cell, but let's say I want to start a new row instead, because if I go with add new cell, it will add one more cell in here, but I don't want this cell to be here. I want this cell to start from the new row, so I choose Start New Row. And I can also add the custom style to this particular row. And then I press Add Item again. And now I will add a new cell. And let's say I will add some text and will add a new cell in the new row. So you can also add a link, set an image or an icon. And let's go with the icon this time and select an icon from the list. Like so, and you can choose the position for the icon before or after the text. In the Advanced tab, you can set the column and the row span. And you can also set this particular cell as a table heading. Later in the style tab, we can tweak the gap between the icon and the text. Now, if I want to add some more items in this row, I will proceed and create a new item. And then when I'm finished with this row and I want to create a new one, as you remember, I need to click Add Item and choose Start New Row in the Action dropdown. Now let me quickly add a couple more rows and we will go on to the Style tab. So I'm ready with the basic setup. And now let's head over to the Style tab and see what style and settings we've got for the table module. So here you can set the general table width, the table alignment, the column width, and the border radius. Let's go with the border radius as 10. And before we move on, let me show you that you've got one more tab in here saying settings. And here you can enable the sorting table option. If you click on it, you'll be able to sort your columns. Like so. And if you toggle the responsive table option to yes, it will allow your table to be scrolled horizontally. And here you can choose the devices on which this option will work, like on mobile devices, on tablets, and on desktop. So let's get back to the Style tab. Here you can apply the styles for the table header, such as the behavior on normal and on hover, the typography settings, the color of the text, the background color, padding. Let's actually add some padding in there. So it looks nice. If you want to apply any border. And there's also an option to set the color for the border and hide the border for header container. So this border will only be visible in here and it will only divide the items in your header. And here are the settings for the icons, images, and sorting icons that you can have in your table header. We actually don't have any icons or images in the table header, but we do have icons in the table body. Let's add padding again. Here you see that you can tweak the typography settings, set the row color and the row background color, and you can also enable this striped row option, and it will allow you to set the color for the even rows. Like so, we can change the background color and the text color. You can also set the custom link color, set the alignment and the vertical alignment. And here are the typography settings for the icons and images. We can make the icons a little bigger and increase the gap between the text and the icon. So here it is. Now you know the basics of creating tables with the Elementor Page Builder and JetElements plugin. If you liked the video, leave a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to check the links in the description down below. You can find the links to JetElements plugin, to my store, to WordPress theme in the description, as I have said before. Thank you for watching!